Hi friends, today we are going to see about ART protocol. Okay, it's a very interesting thing. This ART, and the expansion of ART is actually Highway Addressable Remote Transducer. That's the expansion of ART protocol. We'll see how, what is this ART protocol, how it works. Okay, so basically if you see, for ages in all the measurement loops they've been using current loop. This is the most standard method for transmission of industrial parameters. So current loop. So the current loop is normally 4 to 20 milliamperes. So that's the current loop, that using the current loop only the data is transmitted. Okay. So for 4 to 20 milliampere current loop, it is sufficient. You have simple two wire setup is sufficient. A simple two wire setup is sufficient. It is quite cost effective and very simple to use. Okay, so this is your PLC, and your sensor can directly connect to your PLC via a 4 to 20 milliampere current loop. So what is this 4 to 20 milliampere? Okay, that's the current standard for transmission. Suppose you take a process, you'll take a simple process, and we have the different process values. Okay, for example, this is a tank. We are concerned about the level of the tank. So say the tank is at zero level, 0% filling. This you call it as 0%. Say this is some residual amount of water is there. So this is called as you call it as lower range limit. This is called as lower range limit. Okay, this is what you normally refer it as. For example, so the actually what I mean by lower range limit, for example, you are using a temperature process. You are measuring a temperature from 35 to 95 degrees centigrade. Okay, then for this process, 35 is the lower range level. 35 is the lower range level and 95 is the upper range level. Okay, what I mean by lower range and higher range is, it is nothing but the minimum and maximum value that can be recorded. That is for the process value. Okay, so what we want to infer from this particular aspect is the lower range value will corresponds to a 4 milliampere, and the higher range value will correspond to a 20 milliampere. Okay, so for example, if your process value varies from 35 to 95, 35 represents as 4 milliampere and 95 represents 20 milliampere. So if from your output you are getting 20 milliampere, which means that it is measuring the maximum temperature of 95 degrees centigrade. That's the meaning of it. Okay, so just a translation. Okay, fine. Now what is a very great advantage of using this 4 to 20 milliampere? Okay, so this particular current loop, a single 2 ampere 24 volt DC supply can drive a dozen of sensors. That is a very important aspect. It can drive a dozen of sensors. It can be a pressure sensor, it can be a variety of temperature sensors, it can be a variety of flow sensors, analytical sensors. Okay, that's a very, very important advantage. A single 2 ampere 24 volt DC supply can drive dozens of sensors via this current loop. Another important thing is the data can be transmitted even for long distance, up to 1000 meters. Up to 1000 meters data can be transmitted through a 18 gauge wire without any appreciable loss. That is another advantage of using current loops. And another important advantage of having current loops is the live zero feature. So what I mean by live zero feature is, we have told that the lower range limit is 4 milliampere and the upper range is 20 milliamperes. Okay, so if suppose your output is going to give 0 milliampere, that means there is some disconnection in the wire, which indicates a disconnection in the wire. So it is nothing but minimum value should be 4 milliampere. If you get 0 milliampere, it indicates there is some disconnection. So this feature is called as live zero feature. This feature is called as live zero feature. Okay, so this 4 to 20 milliampere current loop has been used traditionally in industries for transmission of parameters from our sensors to the controllers. Okay, now but the problem with the conventional 4 to 20 milliampere is it can send only one value at a time. It can send only one value at a time. So conventionally the data will go to your A to D converter, and your output precision Okay, the granularity is confined only to the precision of the analog to digital converter that is used. For example, if you are using an analog to digital converter with 16 bit precision, okay, so you have 0 to 65,535 levels, which means that, for example, if I measure a pressure of 0 to 1000 psi, so 1000 by 65535, it indicates 0.015. So the precision is 0.015. Okay, so the value of the LSB is going to be 0.015. So that is the level of precision you can get. Again, the output precision depends upon the precision of the A2D converter. So A2D converter precision is the thing that matters. Okay. So now we have seen the conventional 4 to 20 milliampere. Now we'll take another example of analog transmission, which is nothing but our conventional telephone lines, which is having 48 volt DC electrical. Okay, the conventional telephone lines. What happens in the conventional telephone lines is, whenever the person speaks, the sound wave is converted into an analog sine wave and it is transmitted. Again, this sound wave, it is converted back to the original sound waves at the receiver side. This is your conventional signal. Okay, this is what your phones normally use. Okay, the analog signal that is being transmitted over a wired telephone lines, this is what happens. Now, in this conventional analog transmission, the standard that is adopted for transmission is called as Bell 202 modem standard. Okay, Bell 202 modem standard is the communication standard, and it actually uses audio frequency shift keying. Actually, it will produce a single sine wave having two components. One is 1200 hertz, second one is 2200 hertz. 1200 hertz represent a bit 1 and 2200 hertz represent a bit 0. So you will have a continuous sine wave. Wherever we have 1, it will have a 1200 hertz. Wherever we have a 0, it will have a 2200 hertz. This is a Bell 202 modem standard. Okay, and basically it is a kind of half duplex communication, that is communication in a one direction. Okay. Now, what we're trying to explain here is the original telephone line as an analog communication. The original telephone line as an analog communication. Okay, sound wave is converted to sine wave, analog communication values. It is being transmitted over the line and it is reconverted back to sound waves. Okay, now what happens if you mix the Bell 202 modem standard with your analog signal? What will happen? It will give you some more additional information. The advantage of adding this particular digital signal with the conventional analog signal will help you to give more information. This feature is already available in your phones. This is, you call it as caller ID feature. Okay, so the original analog transmission will be taking place. Along with it, the caller ID is also transmitted. The caller ID is a digital information. So the digital information is added to the analog information and it is transmitted. This way of communication will be more effective because the original analog signal is also there. Additional information is added in the form of a digital signal to your original signal. And most importantly, this digital signal will in no way affect your actual analog signal. It will no way affect your actual analog signal. So this is a very effective way of transmitting a data. Along with your analog signal, you are transmitting your digital signal also. So the digital signal will have additional information. Okay, now the same scenario takes place in the industry also. What they do is that we have the conventional 4 to 20 milliampere current loop. We have the 4 to 20 milliampere current loop. Along with this, if you add the Bell 202 modem standard, if you add the Bell 202 modem standard, okay, so this signal is called as ART signal. This signal is called as the ART signal. So ART is nothing but you have your analog signal 4 to 20 milliampere conventional signal will be there. To that, your digital signal is added. So what this digital signal will have is, it will have information such as the device status, device parameters, the operating conditions, several parameters can be transmitted. So this way, it will increase the productivity. In industries, this particular way of transmitting a data will definitely increase the productivity, because along with the original analog data, you also have a digital information. More information is sent via the same pair of 4 to 20 milliampere current loop. Okay. Another thing is, so I'm just comparing this to a pigeon. Okay. So pigeon normally moves from one place to another place. It flies. Okay. That is like your analog communication. Now adding some information to it, something like all this digital information. It is like in olden days, people used to use these types of pigeon for transferring information. They will have the information tied to the leg or their back. So the information, so along with the travel, it will take the information also. So I'm just comparing the ART to a pigeon. Okay. So ART protocol is something like a pigeon. Along with the original transmission from one point to another point, it also carries additional information. Okay. This additional information is a digital signal. That's what I'm comparing our pigeon to a ART protocol. Fine. Okay. Another important advantage of this kind of doing, for example, in our conventionally, our sensor is connected to the actual PLC. Okay. Now, if you want to shift this to an ART device, suppose you are connecting an ART device, so there is not much of changes required, because it is again the same current wire, it is again the same current loop. Only thing what we require is, here there should be an hardware controller which will be able to recognize the data that is coming via this ART device. Whatever the data that is coming via the ART device, it should be able to recognize. It should be able to separate which is the analog signal, which is the digital added information. It should be able to separate. That hardware knowledge alone should be added to the controller. Okay, that is called as something called as device description. Okay, it is something like, suppose you buy a new device which you want to connect to your PC. What normally people will do, they will provide a CD which contains the drivers. Okay, then only your PC will recognize this particular device will do this operation. In a similar manner, whenever you purchase an ART protocol sensor, it will also have a device driver. Okay, this is called as device description. This device description has to be added into your PLC. Thereby, it will be recognizing what is the kind of data that is coming, which is the analog data, which is the additional information. Those things it will be able to recognize. Okay, so shifting from a conventional sensor to an ART-based sensor does not have much of cost, because it is going to use the same pair of 4 to 20 milliampere current loop with some light modifications. Okay, so the shifting is easily possible. That's what we wanted to infer here. Okay, so this is your typical ART protocol, your typical ART architecture. So wherein you have a good number of field devices that are connected. Okay, and this is your 4 to 20 milliampere current loop. And very important advantage of having this particular ART protocol is, basically it follows a master-slave architecture. It follows a master-slave architecture. Furthermore, this particular ART can get input from multiple masters. It can get input from multiple masters. That is the advantage. Okay. So here you have a Modbus link which we'll take up in the next sessions. Okay. So as of now, you have the primary controller, something a PLC or something. So suppose this is your SCADA unit. Okay, this is your primary master and you have some secondary master. So it can get inputs from multiple masters. That is the beauty of ART protocol. Okay. And we can configure, calibrate and all the diagnostic data from the control room or from other location wherever the ART data is accessible. Okay. So now we are actually stepping into, so now knowing what the ART signal will look like, we'll just step into this actual ART. Why this name? It is ART, highway addressable remote transducer. As we all know that it is a sensor basically. It is basically a sensor or a transducer. That's what the first term. We are coming from the last. So it is a transducer. Okay. So inside an industry, there will be numerous parameters to be measured. Okay. So you'll have numerous ART modules placed in different place. So it tells you about remote. Okay, it is a remote transducer. Transducer placed in remote locations. That is what as remote transducer. Okay, whenever you connect everything on a network, each particular device will have a specific address. Each device has a specific address. That's what I mean by addressable. Each device is addressable. Okay, so something like a name, calling you by a person by a name is similar to that. Each device has a particular address. The fourth aspect is, it is in a highway. What I mean by highway here is a network. It is a network. In a network of sensors, each particular sensor is addressable. Okay, that's what is the meaning of highway, addressable, remote transducer. Typically in a architecture, maximum of 63 devices can be connected. Maximum of 63 devices can be connected using your ART protocol. Okay, so all these devices will communicate again with your PC. That is, I mean the controller or your SCADA unit. Okay, so whenever we are shifting from our thing, I told you it is a master-slave architecture and the device transmits. So the control from the master to the device actually comes in the form of, this is a request. The request comes in the form that is shown. It will be coming in this form. Okay, so the request data will be something looking like this. So it will have a node. So from which node it is referring, what is the actual process value that has to be measured. Okay, so what is the value it is reading, any other information or commands that has to be sent, and some immediate data or some immediate code that is to be sent. So that will be the nature of the data that is being sent from the master to the slave. Okay, or you can think it as a client server. Okay, from your master controller to your actual ART controller, this is the way the data is transmitted. Okay, and another important aspect of ART is you have something called as ART communicator. Using this ART communicator, you can program your sensor and you can get the data. It is a parallel line. You can get the data, whatever be thing. Okay, this will be particularly useful whenever the actual ART module is placed in a very hazardous location. In that case, it is not possible for us to go and configure the sensor directly in the location. So in those areas we can use an ART communicator. So when and where you have the sensor data, it can be accessed. Okay, and as I told earlier, you can have multiple masters. Okay, normally even though we can connect 63 devices at a time, it is not normally followed. The one aspect is, it will actually slow down your actual communication. Okay, most preferred is either 1 or 2 per current loop. 1 or 2 is preferred, and it can handle controls from multiple masters. For example, ART communicator is a secondary master and your PLC or your SCADA unit is your main master. Okay, and as I told earlier, your analog value will not be affected by the sensor measurement data, because if you see, this is your digital data that is transmitted, always it has an amplitude 1. Okay, if you take the average of it, it is an average, and the net effect is 0. The net effect is 0. Only the amplitude change will be with respect to your 4 to 20 milliampere current loop. So your digital data that is added with your analog data will in no effect affect your actual analog signal. That is the information that I want to refer. Okay. So what are the different information that are sent along with the analog signal? Along with the analog signal, around 35 to 50 different information can be sent. Some of them are the measurement variable, the device status, that is, what is the condition of the device, whether it is switch on or off, the diagnostic alerts, like what is the sensor value, whether it is in range or it is exceeding the range, basic configuration parameters like upper limit, lower limit, then tag name of the device. So many information can be sent along with your analog signal. Okay, and another important beautiful aspect about ART is, it is multivariable. Okay, for example, you are connecting an ART flow meter, It can assess your mass flow rate, quality flow rate, qualitative flow rate. It will give you a volumetric flow rate. It will give you the temperature. It will give you density. Several parameters can be communicated over a single communication loop. Okay, that's another very important. It is a multivariable instrument. It's a perfect choice for multivariable instrument. Okay, and the entire ART protocol is maintained by a vendor independent association. It is called as ART Communication Foundation. Okay, thereby, even if you change some other device, interchange with some other manufactured device, it is not going to affect your any way in the process. Okay, so this way it makes your implementation, maintenance and troubleshooting completely easy. That's the beauty of ART protocol. As I told earlier, you will have a data description file. This is like your device driver. So this file has to be loaded into your configuration station and your handle communicators. Thereby, it understands what is the kind of data that is being. So it will be able to interpret the data better. That's the purpose of this data description. Okay. So this is about the ART protocol. So ART protocol is the protocol that is most commonly used for industries for data transmission between the actual PLC and the device. Okay. It can be a ART sensor, it can be a ART flow meter, it can be a diagnostic system. All these can be connected to your actual controllers by using this. So what main thing you need to remember is, along with the original communication current loop 4 to 20 milliampere, all the additional information is added in the form of a digital signal. That is the key takeaway from ART protocol. Okay. Thank you.